OnePlus provided second Android Q developer preview for OnePlus 6 and 6T based on Oxygen OS. And today we have second Android Q developer preview for OnePlus 7 and 7 Pro. But this is based on Hydrogen OS. So we might soon get Android Q DP2 based on Oxygen OS also. If you guys haven't checked the video of OnePlus 6 and 6T running Android Q DP2, link will be given in the description below. You can check that out. So this is my OnePlus 7 Pro. And they have mentioned Android Q DP2 on their OnePlus Chinese forum. I'll include all the links in the description below, Android Q DP2 along with rollback package. So to install that, you need to keep few things in mind. Make sure your device is charged more than 30% and you have taken complete backup of your device, because this will entirely delete your data. So I've already taken the backup. After that, what you have to do is you need to download the file and place it inside the internal storage. So this is the Android Q DP2. Place it inside internal storage. After that, go to settings, system update, tap on the gear icon towards the right top corner, select local upgrade and choose the update package. Once installation process is completed, just hit reboot system. So device have been successfully booted up. Let me complete the initial setup. So now let's take a look at the software information by going to settings, about phone, and here you can see Hydrogen OS version is 9.5. under Android version, Android version is 10, security patch is 5th May 2019 and the build date is 31st May. Hydrogen OS don't come with Google Apps pre-installed, but you can just install the Google Play Store application. I've tried installing Google Play Store. It opens up okay, but the thing is, it does not download any kind of applications. Whenever you try to download any application, it just crashes. I've tried almost everything to make it work, but that did not help me out. One more annoying bug is with the launcher. So launcher always keeps crashing whenever you open any type of applications. You'll see this message of OnePlus launcher keeps crashing. Here launcher version is version 3.3.4, and do not try to update OnePlus launcher. If you update, then it will be completely unusable. But you can still use third party launchers instead of OnePlus launcher. And now with Android Q, we get few custom icons available. So here you can see, you'll see around 5 to 6 pre-installed custom icons and which can be changed from here. This will be a quick setting panel where you'll have the square shape of quick setting tiles. Now brightness slider is at top, and we also have features like screen recorder and Zen mode pre-installed. Towards the left hand side we have shelf, and there are no changes in this. Basic things like calling, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi and warp charging is working fine. On previous Android Q developer preview, media transfer was not working, but on this build, media transfer works fine. Talking about camera application, so camera version over here is version 3.3.10, and that also seems to be working fine. Now let's go inside the settings. Here also you will see square shapes in front of every settings panel. Under Wi-Fi and internet, VoLTE services seems to be working fine. We have both the bands working over here under Wi-Fi, which is 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz. Bluetooth also doesn't have any kind of issues. Under display, adaptive brightness is working fine. Night mode is also working fine, which was not working on the Android Q developer preview for OnePlus 6 and 6T. Reading mode does not work. Screen calibration also not working here. Then we have screen refresh rate, which is 90Hz and 60Hz, and it is working fine on this build. Screen resolution also doesn't have any kind of issues. Quad HD and Full HD works fine. We also have video enhancer mode. Ambient display also seems to be working fine. Then our sound and vibration, we have all the basic settings available, but Dolby Atmos is missing. With this latest Android Q developer preview, they have also added the new navigation gestures. But sometimes this navigation gestures does not perform well. Under lock screen and security, fingerprint and face unlock, both of them are working fine. There are no issues at all. After that we have privacy, under which we have privacy manager. Battery consists of battery saver mode, battery optimization, and we also have options of advanced optimization. Under utilities we have gaming mode, which includes fanatic mode and also supports haptic feedback enhancement. OnePlus Lab consists of DC dimming, and that seems to be working fine. Under settings we have these gestures, which includes full screen gestures, 2-button navigation gestures and 3-button navigation gestures. We also have dark theme available, which can be found inside system, accessibility, and here we have the option of theme. If you try to change it to dark, so there are no changes done in the app drawer. But if you check the quick setting tiles, here you can see only few tiles are visible after enabling dark mode. So this is completely buggy as of now. And Hydrogen OS Developer Preview 2 version is 9.5. So guys, this was a quick look on Android Q Developer Preview 2 based on Hydrogen OS for OnePlus 7 and 7 Pro. Now let me also show you the benchmark results with Geekbench application. Antutu benchmark application did not work, so I won't be able to show you the results of Antutu benchmark app. But with Geekbench application, single core has scored 3549, wherein multi core have scored 11300. So guys, coming on to the conclusion, as of now this is not meant to be used as daily driver. There are lots of bugs available, but still if you want to give a try, you can go ahead and install. All the download links will be given in the description below. And if you have any kind of questions, you can let me know in the comment section below. As of now, only this much in this video. Hope you like the video, and if you like the video, then do give me a thumbs up. Also, if you are new to my channel, then do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.